Okay, so we've got these three little bits of machine learning here, and there are a lot of tools and techniques that are inside that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's great, and we're going to be trying to teach you a lot of those tools and techniques and sort of ways to connect them together. So by the way, as Michael was pointing out, there are kind of ways that these things might help each other. Unsupervised learning might help supervised learning, but it's actually much deeper than that. It turns out you, even though unsupervised learning is clearly not the same as supervised learning at the level we've described it, in some ways they're exactly the same thing. It's supervised learning, you have some bias. Oh, it's a quadratic function, induction makes sense, all these kind of assumptions you make. And in unsupervised learning, I told you that we don't know whether this cluster is better than this cluster, dividing by sex is better than dividing by height or hair color or whatever. But ultimately, you make some decision about how to cluster, and that means implicitly there's some assumed signal. There's some assumed set of labels that you think make sense. Oh, I think things that look alike should somehow be clustered together, or things that are near one another should be clustered together. So in some ways, it's still kind of like supervised learning. You can certainly turn any supervised learning problem into an unsupervised learning problem. Right? So in fact, all of these problems are really the same kind of problem.
Yeah, well, there's two things that I'd want to add to that. One is that in some sense, in many cases, you can formulate all these different problems as some form of optimization. In supervised learning, you want something that labels data well. And so the thing you're trying to optimize is, find me a function that does that. We're going to score it. In reinforcement learning, we're trying to find a behavior that scores well. And in unsupervised learning, we usually have to make up some kind of a criterion, and then we find a way of clustering the data or organizing the data so that it scores well. So that was the first point I wanted to make. The other one is, if you divide things by sex and you're a virgin, then there's numerical instability issues.
Did you learn about that on the street?
I learned it in a math book.
Yes, you did. I'm going to move on with it. So here's the thing.
Right.
Everything Michael just said, except the last part, is true. But there's actually a sort of deeper thing going on here, to me. If you think about the commonalities of everything we've just said, it boils down to one thing. Data. Data, 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 data. Data is king in machine learning. Now, Michael would call himself a computer scientist.
Oh, yeah.
And I would call myself a computationalist.
What?
I'm in a college of computing, not a department of computer science. I believe in computing and computation as being the ultimate thing. So I would call myself a computationalist, and Michael would probably agree with that just to keep this discussion moving.
Let's say.
Right. So we're computationalists. We believe in computing. That's a good thing.
Sure.
Many of our colleagues who do computation tend to think in terms of algorithms. They think in terms of, what are the series of steps I need to do in order to solve some problem? Or they might think in terms of theorems. If I try to describe this problem in a particular way, is it solvable implicitly by some algorithm?
Yeah.
And truthfully, machine learning is a lot of that. But the difference between the person who's trying to solve a problem as an AI person or as a computing person and someone who's trying to solve a problem as a machine learning person is that the algorithm stops being central. The data starts being central. And so what I hope you get out of this class, or at least part of the stuff that you do, is understanding that you have to believe the data, you have to do something with the data, you have to be consistent with the data. The algorithms that fall out of all that are algorithms, but they're algorithms that take the data as primary, or at least important.
I'm going to go with co-equal.
So algorithms and data are co-equal?
Co-equal.
Well, if you believe in Lisp, they're the same thing.
Exactly.
All right.
They
so
knew back in the 70s.
So it turns out we do agree on those things.
That was close.
Excellent. So the rest of the semester will go exactly like this, Michael, except you won't see us. You'll see our hands, though.
This side.
You'll there see our hands, though. Thank you, Michael.
Side eye. What?
That was good. That took me back to when I was four.
Senior Wences.
Hmm?
It's called Senior Wences.
Yes, I know.
Yeah, okay.
I remember that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm not that much younger than you. 10, 12 years old.
Oh, come on.
You count gray hairs. Anyway, the point is, the rest of the semester will go like this. We will talk about supervised learning and a whole series of algorithms, step back a little bit and talk about the theory behind them and try to connect theory of machine learning with theory of computing notions, or at least that kind of basic idea. What does it mean to be a hard problem versus an easier problem? We'll move into randomized optimization and unsupervised learning, where we will talk about all the issues that we brought up here and try to connect them back to some of the things that we did in the section on supervised learning. And then finally, we will spend our time on reinforcement learning and a generalization of these traditional reinforcement learning, which involves multiple agents. So we'll talk about a little bit of game theory, which Michael loves to talk about, I love to talk about, and the applications of all the stuff that we've been learning to solving problems of how to actually act in the world, how to build that robot to do something, or build that agent to play a game, or to teach you how to do whatever you need to be taught how to do. But at the end of the day, we're going to teach you how to think about data, how to think about algorithms, and how to build artifacts that you know will learn.
Let's do this thing.
Excellent. All right. Well, thank you, Michael.
Sure.
I will see you next time we're in the same place at the same time.